Recently, the U.S. FDA announced what seemed like a ban on NMN, the most talked about anti-aging supplement. But is it really banned or not? Welcome to Longevity Brief, brought to you by House of Longevity, your source for the latest news in the anti-aging and longevity fields. Now, let's get into it. This supposed ban was the result of a request from a company called Metro Biotech, of which David Sinclair is a co-founder and advisor. In the letter to the FDA requesting information dated December 1st, 2021, Metro Biotech said, "We request that FDA take the preclusion provision seriously to protect the right of companies that have spent significant time and research to develop drugs products from competition from dietary supplements that are clearly new dietary ingredients that have never filed a new dietary ingredient notification prior to the institution of substantial clinical trials." In an FDA letter recently made public in response to a request from a company called Inner Mongolia Kingdom Way Pharmaceutical Limited, the agency rejected the company's request to market and sell a product containing beta NMN as a nutritional supplement. This is where the controversy started. The agency stated, "NMN is an article authorized for investigation as a new drug by the FDA. Under that provision, if an article, in this case NMN, has been authorized for investigation as a new drug for which substantial clinical investigations have been instituted and for which the existence of such investigations has been made public, the article may not be marketed as or in a dietary supplement unless the article was marketed as a dietary supplement or as a food before being authorized for investigation as a new drug." Was the fact that NMN was under investigation as a potential drug ingredient known to the supplement industry and just conveniently ignored? Or is Metro Biotech trying to corner the market of a supplement that has been available on the market for years? In a previous ruling by the FDA regarding the supplement NAC, which had been available for decades, the FDA did not enforce its ban, and over-the-counter sales of n-acetylcysteine continue to this day. Will NMN remain available for consumers while it's being investigated as a drug? Only time will tell. As for Metro Biotech's attempt to corner the NMN market, David Sinclair, a principal of the company and a hero in the longevity and anti-aging space, has remained silent. Hopefully, he'll come clean in the near future and give us confused fanboys some clarity. In the meantime, if you've gotten good results from NMN and live in the US, it might not be a bad idea to make a toilet paper style run on the product, but if you live in Europe or elsewhere, you're still safe. Watch this space for updates on the NMN ban drama, and subscribe to this channel so you never miss a longevity brief.